Well, hello and welcome back to another RV walkthrough. Got a special one for you today. I literally love this floor plan for a gas RV. This is a 2014 Winnebago Adventurer 37F model. Triple slide, V10 chassis. I think it's a 24,000 pound chassis, if I'm not mistaken, for this model. But we're here at Padada RV Center. My name's Taylor Quill, and I'm gonna give you a good look at this coach. We're gonna start on the exterior, give it the four corners look, then we'll check out compartments, the roof, and then jump inside and see the interior. So let's start it off. As you can see, there's a nice big electric awning that comes out over that front passenger side slide. And that slide is only about 18 inches deep, maybe 2 feet, probably 18. So it does give you a decent amount of space over it. And as you can see, you do have those carefree slide toppers on top of every slide with those metal covers. Very nice. You will hear the gin in this video. It's already heating up in Arizona. I gotta keep it cool. Like I said, driver's side, just a massive slide. Not necessarily full body, but it's pretty dang close. The only part it's not actually a slide is the rear bathroom. This is a bath and a half model, if I've not mentioned that yet. All right, and here's the front driver's side. Like I said, it's a great little color scheme. The full body paint looks good. It is already 8 years old, but the paint is in great condition. And you gotta love Winnebago still giving you the option for the driver's side entry door. This is on 22.5 tires. Once we start looking at the compartments, I will give you an idea of the date codes on them. All right, let me open all those up and we'll start on the passenger side front. All right, like I said, starting on the passenger side, we're gonna start all the way up front. You can see your front axle right here. And actually, let's take a peek at this tire while we're up here. They're all Michelin X tires. Look at that, 0421 on this tire. These tires are about a year old, 255 ADR 22.5s. All right, your first compartment, as you can see, it is technically a pass, so you got a little bit of the chassis in the way and some other stuff, but you can fit, I don't know, some skis, some snowboards, stuff like that. Now you'll notice all your front compartments are side latches, all the rears are bottom top lifts. And I think that's because you can see how low this slide is, comparatively speaking, to the bedroom, which you have a lot more room. I love side latch though. Makes life a lot easier when these little struts go out. As you can see, another nice pass-through. This one's a lot more usable. And then there is the inverter. I think that was a 2000 watt. Let's see if I can see the wattage there. All right, hold on. All right, I finally found it. It is a 2000 watt inverter there. All right, now no compartments right here at the entry door. I mean, that is an access port for technicians, but not a storage area. Gonna get a little loud back here. 28.7 gallons on the propane. Water pump up there. Water tank right there. 5,500 for both rooftop ACs. That is a gas gen. And then a small compartment there. And then on the rear here, of course, you do have your backup camera up top, down below. We got a little bit of towing here, 5,000 pounds, and there should be a set, oh, can you even see that? There we go, 7-pin connector. All right, let me jump up top here and show you the roof. Meet you up there. All right, as you can see, let's see if we can zoom in a little bit. One AC, fantastic fan, second AC, top of the slide topper, top of the awning, and then it's kind of hard to see standing on the edge, but the top of the other slide topper there. Good one piece roof here. Looks good too, no bubbles. Doesn't look like I see any issues. All right, we are in the rear on the driver's side, right below that bathroom window. Rear storage compartment. And it is a 50 amp power service. You can see your power transfer switch and then a couple connections for a TV. Fuel fill. Another small compartment. Rear tires are also 21s and Michelin, so they were all replaced at the same time. Here at dump station, gray and black, outdoor shower, sanitization flush, fun stuff. That looks like the back of the four-door reefer. You got a few batteries in here. Got some extra AGMs in here as not an option. It would come standard with the 37F with that big inverter. And the other side of those pass-through storages. can see on the left there a hydraulic pump right there. And that are the compartments. Oh, did I leave this open? I did, check that out. So I love the accessibility. It's quite a jump up in there. You do have an access panel, but I do also love, you have a window here that is power, and I'll show you that when we plug her in inside. And here is actually, if you are interested, VIN, GVW Oz, 24,000 pounds. There you go. All right. So that is the exterior of our 2014 Adventure 37F. Let me get these compartments shut. I'll meet you guys inside. Let's check it out. Alrighty, as we enter in, you will have three exterior steps that come out. And then, I can't remember what was under here, so let's find out. Another battery. Alright, looks probably your ignition battery. So, a couple more steps when you walk in, right to the left at the base of the stairs. Battery disconnect, chassis disconnect, step control, leveling, compartment lights, and awning controls. This is your first peek at the floor plan. All right, let me actually stand all the way back there in that rear bathroom. All right. Once again, one of my favorite gas RV floor plans. It's great. There's a Challenger 37KT also that is a cool little floor plan. For Winnebago purposes, I love this one. So first off, let's start with the mileage. Just under 52, 51,948. On the left side, you have your solar shade, mirror shade. In the middle, of course, your regular monitor and your backup camera, AC controls, generator, coach heat, your fans, and radio power. So nothing too crazy. And I did make a mistake. I was looking at this for a quick second. This is just a sliding window. It's not an electric one. They do electric ones too. Unfortunately, this one is not. I am sorry for being mistaken. Now, once again, you do have a nightshade, a day shade up there. No TV up here. It is got a better location for it. And then the passenger seat does have a nice little extension here. And as you can see, they had a laptop or something. You have a little bit of power, DC power connection there. No, I don't see a regular plug-in. Something to point out. All right. Your seats, manual on passenger side. But you do have a leg rest that comes out. Driver side is power, except for, of course, turning them. I'm a big fan of Winnebago furniture. I say it in every Winnebago Itasca video I do. I mean, their furniture just withstands the test of time. This is white, and it actually looks pretty good. You have a couple small little marks, but no rips, no tears. I mean, it's good. Same with the passenger seat. All right. Now, before we continue on here, the only other thing, like I said, you have three compartments up top. Left and right are the same size. Middle is not as wide, but they are all connected, so it doesn't really matter. On the right side, switch box, and what is that, a Blu-ray player? Blu-ray player. Oh, this is kind of nice. Nice little light to help you see in there. All right, so let's turn around and check out the rest of the coach. So your first slide goes from that corner literally all the way down right to that wall. Your second slide, this corner right here, all the way down right there. And then finally, your bedroom. When we get there, I will show you how that slide works too. So let's look at the front galley area before we get to the kitchen. I'm going to sit down on the couch and look at the viewing angle. It is great. Lots of cabinets, lots of storage. That is a televator, so it does go up and down. Your dinette does come out and give you, just got to find the leaf, give you a much bigger eating area. Could be a four-door table if you want. And before we continue on, let's take a peek at the printouts. There's our sales ad, as you can see, $99,995. There is the exact floor plan we're taking a peek at. Here are some weights and measurements. I tried to highlight it to make it easier. And that 24,000-pound chassis, can I speak? And a couple of the big ones specifically for the 37F. You're going to have to pause. I know I got almost Parkinson hands. I'm a shaker. All right, check out some of the storage. Once again, all three storages up above here with the double doors should be connected. And as you can see, it goes nice and deep in there. power connections right of the TV and left, and then your power TV switch is right here. And this, like I said, will just come down with the push of a button. It does limit your storage down below because that TV obviously takes up some of the depth, but it will completely get out of the way. Beautiful. If you want to use that window, most people will probably keep that TV up. And if you're wondering what those black kind of cords are, not wires, but they're to hold the dinette tables down. One drawer here with all your remotes, and then a little bit of storage down below. And this should be pretty similar on the right side, minus the middle storage, which will be its own kind of separate one. As I said, not as deep because of the TV. A great viewing angle for the TV regardless. Now, on the other side, part of the slide looks to be about 18 inches deep. You have those same overhead storages all connected. I don't know if the two, okay, they're not. So these two are connected, those two are connected. Once again, I gotta show you this furniture. This furniture is phenomenal. Winnebago's been making this couch for quite a while. Expensive to replace, but actually lasts quite a while, even though it is electric. Down below, gotta pull out leg rest, lift that bad boy up. So that'll act, of course, you know, just as a leg rest. But when you make it a sleeper, and you push this button to make her lay flat, it turns into just to a massive sleeping area. Yes, it's not like a real bed. You're gonna have a couple undulations in it, and you see that patch right there on the couch? Point that out. There we go. So, and you can push that a little bit closer so it's fully connected. There is a nice big sleeping area. I mean, wider than a queen bed. Maybe not as long as one of those mattresses, but I love the furniture. I can't speak enough about this little leg rest and this specific couch. Once again, there is a patch there. All right, and then right next to it, you do have like a little reader chair, and that does look like it does recline. And she does. There you go. All right, I gotta put you guys on pause really quick, get this cleaned up, and we'll continue on. All right, let's point out something else while we can access them. All slider windows, nighttime, and daytime. All right, so you should have those nice pull-down shades throughout the whole coach, even behind the TV right there. All right, continuing on, entry door to our left. Right when you walk in, you do hit the kitchen. Kitchen does have a little pop-up leaf. Give you a little bit more of that Corian storage counter space. And then you see you got Corian covers throughout the whole coach. So you can, you know, keep them on while traveling, take them off, use them as counter, extra counter space. Four-door reefer right there should have an ice maker. And then washer dryer prep just to the left. Convection microwave, because there is no oven. I'm trying something new in these videos. Let me back her up and I'm gonna open all these compartments and see how crazy it looks. Okay, it looks a little chaotic, so we're gonna go through this nice and easy. Up top, two storage compartments, three doors, all connected. Down below, I don't know why I always call it a bread box, but you have another little storage there with power connections just to the left. Real backsplash back there. And then, of course, the stovetop, three burner, two covers for it are right there, and then the two bay metal sink covers for it are also under there. There should be, I'm pretty sure there's storage. We're gonna check that in a second. But you do also have three drawers under the stovetop. Those two are the same. This one is a little bit deeper. Oh. And then on the other side, you have four drawers, top three, all the same. Bottom, a little bit deeper. Let me get this other drawer and then I'll show you in there. All right, so we open in here. Under the sink. So I've seen a couple of these 37 apps where they have an area for the Corian tops. It doesn't look like this one has that. So when you are traveling, you'll probably just keep the Corian in position or put it up in storage area. So that is the storage aspect of your kitchen. And of course, like I said, convection microwave up above. Looks like a residential size, not the little small ones. Four-door Norcold fridge. This is going to be one of them three ways, propane, electric, plugged in. Decent size and not super high up. Separate compartment for the freezer right, and then freezer left, like I said, ice maker. And just over a hair more, we have an area for your washer dryer prep. But if you really don't need it, I'm a big fan of pull out drawers. Just helps you organize, help you get stuff to the bag that you never wear. And down below, not pullouts, but you do have another area. If you wanted to put a full stack washer dryer in here, you absolutely could. You probably don't even have to, if you got separate ones, not even take out that area right there. So kind of cool. Now, before we get to the bedroom, right behind me, we have a couple special things. You got your half bath behind this special door number one, and of course your slide control. So slide controls up front, passenger, drivers, you can lock your slides, master control switch, turn that off, bam, can't use the slides. There is a thermostat in the middle that will control both zones. Electric display, generator control monitor, and then of course your inverter control, and then of course a little bit of power connections. All right, so here's your half bath and a leaf on the ground. Corian top, same throughout the bathroom. China toilet, a little bit of that storage down below, and then nothing too crazy over there. You know, magazine rack, toilet paper holder. No medicine cabinet, but you do have some side storage there. And some, I usually call that toilet paper storage. I don't know if that's deep enough. Some more storage there. That's your half bath. Half baths do have AC and heat in them. All right, so you do have a nice big pocket door. It's a double door. I can actually show you right here. That will slide across if you want to make it like a master suite or shut you off from the people on the galley. Now your other slide, like I said, third and final, that corner to that corner. This bed does have to be up when you are in travel mode, I guess. When you have this slide in, you do have to lift this bed up. It does go down with a push of a button. Let me find it. And I'll get this laying flat. It is an Ideal Rest air mattress, so it does have left and right side air bags in them, so you can pop them up for mop, soften them up, whatever you're comfortable with. Now, it is a little bit of a process to get the bed down. You got to sit here and hold it, of course, and like I said, when you're traveling, you got to put it up. But it's gonna look a little weird because there's no air in it right now. But there you go. There is your nice king mattress. I think 72 inches wide, I think, is what the kings are. I could be wrong. Don't quote me on that. And then down below, you had a couple little, I'm not sure, were they storages or access points? Oh, breaker box. Probably somewhere on the other side. All right. Now, in front of the bed, you have a wall closet, a couple drawers, and, of course, your TV. The wall closet's nice. Oh, my God. Come on, light. Turn on now. Oh, there it is. All right. So wall closet in here with the light, a couple extra peel and stick laminate flooring if you ever chinger one up pretty bad. Looks like a little secret storage behind the TV there. Can you access that? Doesn't look like it. Sounds good to know. A little secret storage. Area down below for a game console, DVD player, something along those lines. Nice tall deep drawer there. And then under that one you got two more. And of course this nice big deep drawer here. Guys, there's your closet. That's all you get, I'm sorry. All right. And then as usual, I'm not gonna show you. You probably don't care or need to see them, but connected compartments up above, as you can see, they're decently deep. Another slider door here for the master bath. And then once you get in here, you'll see same Corian tops, good amount of storage, nice china toilet down here. Window to keep you happy, AC vent, medicine cabinets in here, which we will check out in a second. Look at the shower. I'm not quite sure of the pan size because it is angled a little bit differently and there is no skylight, but it is plenty of room. You will be able to bend down and wash your ankles. Now, as usual, like every other bathroom, a little bit of discoloration, a little bit of storage, a little bit of plumbing in the way as usual. I always find these compartments weird because you have to have the lid shut to access them. All right, and then, like I said, medicine cabinet. You got a little bit of storage there, and then one more here on the right side. Come on, you better be deep enough for toilet paper. It is. All right, guys, that's it. 2014 Winnebago Adventure 37F that we are selling in Tucson, Arizona for $99,995. Now, let me get these compartments in, give you an idea how it looks while you are traveling, clean her up and get all these tops on. I'll be right back with you. All right, I am right at the slide controls. Look into the rear bedroom. You could still technically sleep on the bed if you set both airs at the same kind of firmness and sleep this way. You could still get back to the rear bathroom if you wanted to. You still have access to two top drawers, closet, washer, dryer, or drawer storage. Your half bath is fully accessible. The fridge is accessible too. You gotta do one of them little side steppers to open her. Kitchen's accessible. Now, it's my love-hate relationship with this floor plan. This specific little bucket chair right here makes it tough walking by. I turned it to the side because it does give you just a hair more room than going this way, as you can see. So we will keep her on the side. Let me walk up, do a little sidestep action here. It is still accessible. I mean, if you're got a little bit thicker thighs, it might be tough to get through. You may want to consider taking out that chair. But there you go. There is, standing on the doghouse, looking down. Your accessibility. So really, really useful, opened up, pretty tight closed, but hey, all that means is you are closer to that TV watching it when the slides are in. All right, let me jump outside, show you the exterior, and we'll let you guys go. I am sorry about that sun glare, but here are two slides fully in on the passenger side. And then of course on the driver's side, your big old super slide is all the way in too. And there's your walkthrough, guys. I'm going to put a link to this coach on our website in the description down below, plus all my contact info if you want to inquire about purchasing it or just have a couple questions. We are, like I said, located in Tucson, Arizona. We are a dealer, family run. Been doing this for about 25 years. And we are Carfax certified, so let me know if you want one. Thank you so much for viewing, everyone. Hope you guys have a great day.